guys, welcome to day 12, is it? I think, maybe, possibly, perhaps. I have just finished filming the hamster mail unboxing video. Went very well, I'm very, very happy with the products. That video should be coming out, I want to say over the weekend sometime, possibly Monday. It depends on how long it takes me to edit it. I've also been filming some clips for upcoming videos, 2019 videos. Nothing particularly fancy or special, just scenes that had to be filmed at some point. Might as well do them today. So I've had a fairly productive day. It's now 4 o'clock in the afternoon and I'm about to head out to collect some pine branches because I realized I haven't got any, and that is what's been missing. I couldn't figure out what exactly was missing from our home, and it is the smell of Turkish pine. So I'm gonna go out and get some pine branches. I'm gonna take Rodney with me, and hopefully that'll be successful.
Can we just take a moment to appreciate how green the fields are looking? This is after just a couple of hours of rain over the course of a couple of days.
It's not too cold out today, but I'm feeling it on my nose and my ears and my fingertips. Everything else is fine, just the end bits.
Oh, of course you found a nice big patch of grass to munch on your horse. So I can see a decent sized Turkish pine up on the hill there. It's at a bit of an angle though. Not sure whether it's worth climbing. I feel like there were way more pines down here last year. It's a bit weird. Where have they all gone? Because there's no stumps. It's not like they've been cut down. Okay, so I found my pine trees. Ooh, there we go. Nice one there, big one there. Hopefully these don't have any caterpillars in them because I don't want to disturb anyone. It's not really hot enough for the caterpillars yet, so I don't think there's going to be anything here. What are you crying about, huh? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut a few of these sprigs off the lowest branches. I'm not going to go crazy because I don't want to harm the tree. But I'm just going to take a couple off of each tree and then that should be plenty.
Can you guys hear that owl? It's so excited about something. Okay, it's getting really dark now, so I need to head back because Rodney is a little bit frightened of the dark. It's a little bit of a wuss, and he's gonna start getting stressed out. So how do I get back down here? Hey, Rodney, what's this? Is it your ball? You ready? Ready? Fetch. Fetch. Good boy. Thank you. Ready? Fetch. Now I know that jealousy is a pretty complicated emotion. It can stir up feelings of anger and resentment, and in general can be pretty hard to deal with, but you're just gonna have to deal with it. Part of me really wants to pretend that it's cool and quirky that I'm dressed like a unicorn, but I am all too aware of how over unicorns the whole world is. It's like I turned up 10 years late to a party and decided I was gonna dance anyway. And if you're thinking there isn't more, oh no. It's a full-on onesie. It's a uni onesie. I was cold, this was warm, that's the only explanation you deserve.
You're not thrilled with it, are you? Dear old Dodger is testing out his new harness. Not the biggest fan. I put it on him and for the first 10 minutes he just stood in a very strange arched back position and just stood there. Because apparently he doesn't get what this is. And that's fine, that's okay. He's had it on for about an hour now though, and he seems a little more confident in it. I mean, he's walking a bit funny.
He's kind of walking sideways. I'm pretty sure by his walk tomorrow he's going to be fine and used to it, and hopefully it's going to make things a lot easier because he's getting really big. And fortunately I'm staying the same size, so that's... Oh, you got your pig. Okay. Well, now that's an interesting shadow to have. Oh, wait. If I lean like this, it's like the shadow of a giant seagull flying overhead. Yes? No? Maybe? There's no one around to tell me if I'm right.
Using some of the pine needles I collected, I'm going to be making a little bit of stovetop potpourri. This particular recipe is a very simple and very common one, so there's a good chance you've seen it before. And if you haven't, try to act like you're entertained. Doing this, it's just occurred to me that I have now had this knife for an entire year. And the reason I know that is because this time last year, when I first got this knife and it was still very, 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 very sharp, I was cutting oranges and I slipped and I sliced my finger open and there was blood and orange everywhere. And there was orange inside my finger and it burned more than anything has ever burned in my life. Little tip, if you ever have an open wound, don't put orange juice in it. I wanted to hack off the entire finger to make it stop. Now I have my lovely sliced orange, which I am very tempted just to chow down on. I freaking love oranges, best fruit in the world. Bananas, of course, coming in a very close second. Oh, that's a ploy for getting more comments in the comment section. What's your favorite fruit? Tell me down below. Make as many comments as you need to. Once your water's at the stage where it's peeling the paint off your walls, you need to bring down the heat a little bit, bring it down to a simmer. You do not want to be boiling your potpourri, because what will end up happening is you will boil away your water far too quickly, you'll forget about it, and not only will you almost burn your house down, but you will also have a house that smells not of lovely pine needles and orange, but of burnt pine needles and burnt orange and bad cooking, and your neighbors will hate you. I am definitely not speaking from experience. First thing I'm gonna do is pop in the little bit of cinnamon. I'm gonna slide in the pine needles, and then, as you would expect, top it off with a few slices of orange. Now you can pop a lid on this for a little bit, just while it continues to simmer, and then take the lid off and it will fill your home. But just remember, do not leave something like this unattended. Don't be walking out of your home and thinking you're gonna come back to it smelling lovely. That's silly and dangerous. Don't do it. And just make sure you check in on it every so often. You might need to top it up with a little bit of water. You do not want the water boiling away. As mentioned, it will just make your house smell like burn. As long as you're responsible with it, it will keep your house smelling lovely for the entire day. Look at these three adorable snuggle beans. My little blondies all cuddled together, huh? Yeah. Where's the outcast? Where's he gone? I bet I know where he is.
Yeah, on the sofa where you shouldn't be. Huh? Why aren't you snuggling up with everyone else? What's wrong?
Fluffy Hammy asks something a lot of you guys have been asking, and that's, how do you make the fall leaf bedding you used in Iodine's cage? I've mentioned this several times, but I will say it again. To make that, I used the exact same method as I showed in a video tutorial a couple of years ago, where I use a washing machine and a pillowcase. Now in that video, I used plain white paper to make plain white bedding, but to make the colored stuff, all I use is colored kitchen tissue. That's it, it's nothing special, just colored kitchen tissue. Follow that method. It takes a little while to make. It can be a bit time consuming, but it's totally worth it. The bedding is really soft, it's really nice, it's really colorful. And of course, if you don't have paper bedding available to you commercially, like I don't, it's a good option. Yungo asks, what method do you find to be the best when interacting with Iodine if she isn't overly keen on being handled? General rule is, if your hamster isn't keen on being handled, don't handle them. Of course, the exception with this being if they are not tame, you do need to tame them first, but if after they're tamed, sometimes they don't want to be handled, they're just not interested in playing with you, just don't play with them. You can do other things, you can sit and chat with them by their cage, you can just watch them and enjoy them. You don't have to handle them, and if they don't want to be handled, it's better to leave them alone. You've always got to put their needs first, listen to their body language, listen to what they are telling you and what kind of mood they're telling you they're in, and just remember to respect your animal and respect their personal space. It's just as important as yours is. Mary Brooks says, I know you were planning on moving last year but didn't find anything. Are you still looking, or have you decided to stay where you are? Right now, we are not actively looking, but we are not planning on staying in the apartment. It's a bit of a weird situation. We have to stay living in a certain area because of Dan's work and because of where our vets is and because of the fact we don't have a car, so we have to have easy access to all basic amenities like supermarkets. So we don't have many options in terms of location. Unfortunately, the area that we have to live in
doesn't really have anything available to rent right now. What little is available at the moment is mainly stuff that's outside of our budget and smaller than our current home, so there's not really much point in moving right now. We're not going to get a better deal. We are still keeping an eye out, but like I say, we're not actively looking right now because there's just a bunch of other stuff going on. Pet Notebook asks, what got you into hamsters? The answer to that is ferrets. I know. Makes a lot of sense, doesn't it? I've told this story many times, but the long and short of it is I was looking into getting ferrets. I'd never ever had hamsters before. I actually really did not like hamsters. I only knew of Syrian hamsters existing, and I thought they were really ugly, horrible things. This was 8 years, yeah, it'll be 8 years ago this December I got my first ever hamsters. But I was looking into ferrets, and I'd gone into a pet shop to gather an estimate of how much supplies were going to cost for a ferret, and while I was in there I saw some Roborovsky hamsters for the first time, and I totally fell in love with them. And it was Roborovskys that got me into the hamster keeping hobby, and now this is where I've ended up. I make YouTube videos on hamster care for a living, all because of ferrets. Yeah. Mia Harrison asks, approximately how many hours a day do you spend looking after, playing with, feeding, etc. your pets? If I'm honest, I don't know the exact amount of time in hours because I don't really count it. Pet care is kind of an ongoing thing that just you do little bits of it throughout the day. So it's like 2 minutes here, 5 minutes there, an hour here, an hour there. You know, you don't really sort of set aside, well, at least I don't, set aside specific blocks of time to do things. You go about your day, you care for your pets throughout the day, and it's just, it's just part of your daily life. So I'm not sure, it probably works out as a good chunk of it, because you've got, you know, dog walking and time spent with a mouse, which is a couple of hours at least. And then if the hamsters want to come out, they come out for about, well, depending, 20, 30 minutes. So I'm sure it adds up to a good few hours. Frey369 asks, do you think you would ever keep a group of dwarf hamsters? I have had groups and pairs in the past on my channel. You can find lots of that if you are willing to go back long enough, because there's just way too much content to go through. No, I've had experience with groups and pairs, and it would be nice to have at least a pair again, but in order to keep pairs safely and responsibly, you have to have quite a specific setup. You also need to have the space for a spare cage should they need separating, and I don't have any of that stuff right now. I'm not in a position where I could responsibly keep a pair of dwarf hamsters, which is why I've been keeping singles for the last couple of years. And for the final question, a nice simple one, Owen Davis asks, what is your favorite animal in general? My favorite animal is a tiger. I absolutely love cats, big or small, but tigers are the king of all animals for me. So this is where we're gonna be wrapping up today's video. I hope you guys have enjoyed it. If you did, you know the usual things to do. Leave a like, subscribe if you wanna see more. And I will see all of you guys, hopefully, if I get my stuff together, I'll see all of you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye.